In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking. But now, God knows, anything goes.
The Seattle Men's Chorus proudly presents Swellegant Elegance, the music of Cole Porter. Featuring Harvey Fierstein, with a special guest appearance by Diane Schur. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Harvey Fierstein.
Go!
Good evening and welcome to our show. I think Cole Porter would have loved being in this intimate little piano bar. I know he would have loved how we had it decorated. But most of all, I think he would have loved being with good friends just sharing his music. Evan, is that the bobolink waltz you're playing? This was Cole Porter's first published work, which he dedicated to his mother, which is a good thing because she paid to have it published. Cole arrived at Yale University in 1909 with way too much luggage. Like a true overachiever, joined dozens of clubs, including the Mince Pie Club, the Whiff and Poops, the Yale Dramatic Association, where he was reputed to be a major thespian. He burst onto the college football scene as head cheerleader. He also doubled as singer, pianist, conductor, and composer for the Yale University Glee Club. Segued from the Ivy League to the Big Apple, where his wit and extraordinary talent opened Broadway doors. His first show in 1916 was called See America First. The Broadway critics said, See America First, last. It closed after only 15 performances, but in the next 15 years, he wrote 13 more Broadway shows with songs like these.
Oh, there he is.
1919, Cole Porter got married to a woman, Linda Lee Thomas. Now, Cole had inherited wealth, but he married even wealthier. Now, Linda Lee knew that Cole was gay. She also knew of his very close circle of friends, for both were to be discreet. And this marriage of convenience made the couple high society favorites on both sides of the Atlantic. They hobnobbed with the Rothschilds, George Bernard Shaw, Ernest Hemingway, Fanny Bryce, even the Aga Khan. As society's darling, Cole could deliver scathing social commentary with a winning smile and a swift kick.
Awful, something brave, and I'll show you how I write.
A lonesome oyster, every day getting sadder and moister. He thought his home life awfully wet and longed to travel with the upper set. Poor little oyster. Fate was kind to that oyster, we know. When one day the chef from the park casino saw that oyster lying there and said, I'll put you on my bill of fare. Lucky little oyster. See him on his silver platter, watching the queens of fashion chatter, hearing the wives of millionaires discuss their marriages and love affairs. Fishy little oyster. Five-valve social climber, feeding the rich Mrs. Hogenheimer. Think of his joy as he gaily slides down to the middle of a pit inside. Lucky little oyster. After lunch, Mrs. H complains and says to her hostess, boy, you're such a pain. I came to town on my yacht today, but I think I'd better hurry back to Oyster Bay. Scale, oyster. Off they go in the troubled tide, the yacht rolling madly from side to side. They tossed about till that poor young oyster finds that it's time to give up his cloister. Up comes the oyster. Back once more where he started from, he murmured, I haven't a single qualm. For I've had a taste of society, and society has had a taste of me. Wise, Loyster. When the only sound on the empty street is the heavy tread of the heavy feet that belong to a lonesome cop. Aye. Open shop. When the moon so long has been gazing down on the wayward ways of this wayward town, that a smile becomes a smirk. Gotta work. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Diane Shu.
I'm doing fine, Harv.
So we're going to do some Cole Porter tonight?
Yeah, in the key of G.
Ooh, the way you wrote it.
Yeah, I didn't know that until tonight.
Oh, honey, it's your first time, huh?
Yeah.
Well, we'll take it easy.
We're doing a song like this.
Love,
still unspoiled. Love that's only slightly soiled. Love fools me.
Who will buy? Who would like to sample my supply?
Who's prepared to pay the price for a trip to paradise?
Love for sale. Let the poets pipe of love in their childish way.
I know every type of love better far than they.
If you want the thrill of love,
I've been through the mill of love.
Oh, love.
New love. You wanna buy my wares? Follow me and climb them stairs. Love.
For sale.
For rent tonight. In 1937, at the height of Cole's career, tragedy struck. Both his legs were crushed when a horse rolled over him in a riding accident. Over the next 20 years, Cole suffered through some 30 operations. But despite his frail condition, this was his most frantically creative period. He moved from Broadway to Hollywood, scoring such films as Kiss Me, Kate, Can Can, High Society. Cole conquered the silver screen just as he had Broadway.
In the
here, Evan, have a drink. All those songs put me in the mood for love. And look at this bar, empty. You know, Evan, this place kind of reminds me of Brigadoon. You know, where your dream man only comes along once every 100 years.
Thank you.
Cole lived in a world of glamour and elegance, with glittering successes on Broadway and in Hollywood. But fame was bittersweet for a man who sometimes wanted to live outside the spotlight. Cole's last score, written in 1957 for a TV production of Aladdin, included this final irony. Wouldn't it be fun not to be famous? Wouldn't it be fun not to be rich? Wouldn't it be fun? By 1958, Cole's health had deteriorated dramatically. In April, his right leg was amputated, and he spent most of the next